They're gonna paint with some oils in places that I don't know how to use oils, which is everywhere. All right, let's flip this around. No, I said flip. Flip, bloop, there we go. All right, so let's see if I can check my stream manager. Where's my stream manager? So we've got, totally forgot I had all of these oil paints. Let me see if I can get down in here, review everything. So I've got kind of my CMYK version, kind of my version of oil CMYK. Manganese blue hue, Winsor Newton. Got two different magentas, permanent magenta and quinacridone magenta, cadmium yellow pale, charcoal gray, probably should have just, well, this is all I have, got a real gray, titanium white, and this weird ass cadmium green pale, like lime green, that I thought was fun. So we are gonna see what happens with this. So I've just got a cheapo canvas. It's got some smudges on it, so it should be good for a study to just try some things out. And we got our mixture of turpentine and linseed oil as a medium. See how this goes. We got our plates, whatever this is, paper towels. All right, I guess we're gonna dig into this then. We've got some brushes. I don't have a lot of great brushes that are hog's hair. Most of them are water brushes. But I have these, so it's what we're gonna use for now. If I like it, I'll put some, go get some more or something. All right, let's see. So we're gonna take each one of these, squish it on here. Maybe. Too much, but thankfully it's oils and I can save it for later. I also don't know if you're supposed to have like sealed this palette thing. Who knows? Maybe it'll just rot away. Oh, you found your jacket. Where was it?
Under the playpen.
Under the playpen. Great. Mona lost her jacket, her rain jacket, and it's been raining a lot. Somehow got under the playpen. The baby cage. Right, two magentas. Our yellow is nice and grody. Black over here. And white. Maybe. Oh, son of a bitch. Hold on. Not wanting to come
out of your house. Should have got some gloves. Oh well. Yeah, because this is going to be yucky. And then we'll get some of this stuff. It's green, since we're doing lots of greens. Alright, that's our palette. More or less. Brushes, painting medium, where the hell are you gonna go? Down here? Alright, hope that doesn't spill. So like this one's gotta get mixed up, I know.
Oil paint?
Yep.
You might have to keep an eye on her.
I'll listen. Hear footsteps of the little baby.
You might see her come out.
Mm-hmm. Get back up there, oil. Nice and smooth. I'm thinking I'll just coat. There's so much yellow stuff. And yellow's gonna be the basis of everything. Just coat a lot of it in yellow, make a base layer. And then blend everything else up from that. If I can keep this thingy canvas down. Baby. Oh, hold on. Let's go check on the baby.
What happened? What happened?
She wouldn't tell me if she hurt herself. So, I think she's overtired. We shall see. If she keeps crying, then we'll go back in. But, she didn't say that she hurt herself. She's crying. I don't know, like, she just started screaming, so I thought she hurt herself. But she didn't tell me that she hurt herself.
Oh, she's screaming.
Yeah. I went in for her, but she was just calling for you. It sounded like she had hurt herself or fallen out, but she didn't. Stay still, Candace. Poor baby. How smooth this goes on compared to waters or acrylics.
Bye.
sumbitch. Might need to like anchor this down somehow. Hi baby, are you not wanting to take a rest? I see.
We're gonna go see the bounce house.
Oh, cool. You want me to put my paintbrush in the blue paint? That's a good idea. You are full of very good ideas. Let's make the, whatever this is, what is that, the lake? Beaver pond, we'll make it red.
Watch your set. There's a cord. Step over it.
Okay, baby, have fun at the bounce house.
Baby's first bounce house.
Oh, that's right, because she was too young last time.
She's 5 weeks old.
I know.
She didn't go on at that time. She was lame.
I think, did we bring her in?
No. Probably not. Keep moving.
Um, I don't think so. Are you going inside anybody's house?
I don't think so.
If you're outside, you're fine. Bye, see you guys. It's all behind the trees here, but might as well just block it out. And then we'll get the tree, the water line, a little bit. Okay, what do we want to do next? Next we want to do some background stuff. So like some, bring some cyan into it for some greens. Bluish, lightish, bluish, tealish, kind of. I don't know. I'm just layering. I don't know how well layering's gonna work, but I'm just kind of imagining blending the colors. And since they're CMYK, they should blend fairly well together. As long as I don't start adding in black until the very end. Now we can do the background. The sky today is pretty white. So let's block that in. Stop moving, canvas. Cloudy up there now. I'm gonna have to get a screw or something to keep this shit stationary. Or get a different piece of wood. This is just a stretcher bar. Chunk. Keep that. I always have to remember that, like, this stuff doesn't really, it doesn't dry, so. I don't have to rinse my brush out right away. I can switch to a different brush. Whenever I should move the camera. There we go. Sorry for the bumps. That better? Now I'm not so in front of it. Let's see if we can get a thumbtack somewhere. I think my thumbtacks are over at the studio cabin, not this one. What else do I have in here? I got this thing. I don't think that's gonna do. Then I'm just gonna get this hole full of oil paint, and that's my lamp holder. Alright, scratch that idea. We'll just deal. guess I could clamp around that side. Motherfracker.
It's driving me nuts.
Basically just getting like underpainting color block shit down. Friggin' stuff, not staying in place. Friggin' fricks. Fricky fricks. Background trees. About the trees in the back background. Way back here is the darkest. these little brushes, bushes, whatever the shit they are. Kind of in the tree line on the bottom. This place better when there's no campers. Gonna have some more coming in today. Wait, what day is today? Friday? Yeah, more today and tomorrow. But not too many. Which sucks for my parents. But it's so much quieter. I wonder if there's like, I don't know, it's really creepy because yesterday there was this plane, this prop plane that like flew overhead, circled back and forth and back and forth around the campground. And they're like, who is spying on us? We don't want any spies. Please to be going away. Learning and flying over the same place over and over, and we're a good landmark. Or maybe it's some conspiracy which who's surveilling us and looking for ways to take us down, which sounds far-fetched, except it happened like 15 years ago. Jackasses released a report that was just full of false things about like different violations the campground had. None of them were true. But they were just trying to put my parents out of business because my parents wanted to have some sustainable growth and not just greed, greed, greed. Sell, sell, sell. That was when the Cooperstown area was really exploding from the youth Little League camp nearby called the Dreams Park, where they got like 20 baseball fields and like gazillion teams come up every year, and now it's like 90% of our business. Alright, we're trying this brush now. Hey, Bohemian, how you doing, buddy? I got my oil paints out, and it's interesting. I literally have no idea what I'm doing, but I don't care. I'm doing it anyway. Screw it. Trees, at least some blocks of trees, and then I can bring out the shadows and the highlights and all that shit. Tree tree, tree, tree. How you doing, buddy? Oh yeah, it looks good. It's doing something. Oh, I'm gonna go on my knees again. Damn it, I did this. I was painting yesterday too on my knees with some ink. And that did not end well for my knees. But this actually gives me a better vantage point. I hope my head is not in the way. If it is, just yell at me. This keeps falling on me too. I'm like, some bitch, stay still. I'm good, just chilling, cool. That's awesome. What you been up to? I've been like traveling and trying to get back online. May have noticed that the resolution is crap and the graphics are all missing because I'm just running it from my phone. But the internet guy is coming Sunday afternoon and he's supposedly gonna put in this like gigabit ethernet wireless transmitters stuff that should be fabulous, and I'm very much looking forward to. Because where I am right now, it's like the weakest, tiniest little signal. And barely anything for internet. Just like, I think I might have been on like LTE. Oh, gee, I can't kneel very long. It's actually really good for mobile. Oh, good. Good job. Good job, iPhone. This is funny. This is so like out of my wheel well. I'm not used to things not drying right away. It's a little bit like gouache because, you know, you get into it and you can re-wet it, quote unquote, even though it's not wet, you know, like not water-based. But in that sense, it's a little bit like working with gouache. So at least I got that kind of experience to fall back on a little bit, or to draw from. You're on the campground's Wi-Fi. I'm either on the Wi-Fi or just on my like cell signal. Where we are down here, this is like the lowest point where the pond is. The internet repeaters for the rest of the campground are all that way. And there's a big ass metal here. I'll rotate. Ready? So like up there, that's the bathhouse. There's all campsites all up along there. And then there's tent sites along the pond down there. But the repeater is on the opposite side of the bathhouse. So it's like the whole, not only the hill, but the metal buildings in the way. So on Sunday, Mr. Internet Man's gonna come up and put another transmitter on this side. So that, oh shit. Sorry. So that we can have better internet. And then I can hook up to my computer again. Oh, Lord. Yeah. I mean, I like the freedom of the phone and the simplicity of it, but it's got its limitations. It likes to just bounce all over the place. Yeah, signal has been the biggest issue for my streams. I went out in the desert to stream a painting on Wednesday. Totally forgot paper or anything to paint on. Ended up going for a nice hike. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah. Yeah, that sounds about right. Every time I try to get this stuff together and I'm like, wait, what did I forget? Did I remember anything? All right, so if this new setup of my head gets in the way, let's see if it does, since I put it back. I'm never very good at, like, getting the same frame again. I just need some thumbtacks, but there aren't any here. There's some at the other cabin. That sounds good. A nice hike. We have some nice hiking up here too. Not like miles and miles, but we've got 400 acres. And I feel like my head's gonna be right in the way if I'm trying to look at stuff. So
moving over again we go.
I've only used oil outside a couple times, but I do like how long the paints stay open, right? Yes, I feel like that's going to be something I'm going to like, because I really like rewetting gouache and stuff. So if this ends up being like a similar experience, that could be quite pleasant. But that's what I'm kind of thinking, is like if I just use this limited color palette and wet on wet, then I can just blend and build using only like the CMYK colors. And let them blend up together and all that.
Are you using odorless mineral spirits? Nope, I am outside, so I'm using turpentine and linseed oil. Inside, I do have odorless mineral spirits to use. I bought both because I don't want to poison myself unnecessarily. Only necessarily.
Yeah, now I put it like right in my way. I can't see the actual trees I'm painting now. Scoop, 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 scoop. I'll do the stuff above the skyline last. Let's get deep in the back there. Terpenoid, I think that's a turpentine brand of OMS. Oh, yeah. Nope, I'm just using Jasco turpentine. Fatal if swallowed. Good stuff. And then boiled linseed oil with a 3-to-1 ratio as another streamer. So kindly pointed out to me was a good starting point for a ratio to try. Seems to be doing pretty good so far. Get out of here, bug. Oh man, bugs. That's the stuff for dealing with outside. At least with water stuff, water-based stuff, and the bugs land on it, they don't stick. I did not account for bugs. What other brushes do I have? I've got a smaller flat brush. Maybe I'll try that. I gotta get this set up better. I'm like holding brushes in my fingertips and shit. It's fun though. I'm enjoying it. I like the cake batter consistency of things. Alright, let's just get some magenta for the background. was smart, I probably would have left more of that yellow for highlights and just let that be the, and done this, you know, days earlier so that I would have a good background, but I am not smart and I am impatient, and those are not good combinations. You doing it, man? Plein air never hardly gets comfortable. No, it doesn't. But I do like it. Because I'm not, like, I've never been really good with, like, trying to reproduce realism from my imagination. So, but, like, you know, if I've got stuff in front of me, I can usually render it pretty well. I'm out of practice now because I've been doing installation and, you know, performance and all sorts of sculpture stuff the past 10 years or so, but, you know, I took an anatomy class. I was drawing those bones, super hardly rendered, like 80-hour drawings of bones. That was the time. And then I look at those drawings now and I'm like, holy mother of, how did you do that? And I say, I do not know. I do not know. I just did it. Because I was doing it every day. Let's get some more yellow in that. A little bit of medium. I keep forgetting to, like, show the palette. Show the palette. All right, let's try to get some of these bushes. They're all down on the shore. My Delrin easel is pretty much complete. Maybe we can work out a trade and I'll cut you one out. I'm hoping I can still source the hinges. Ah. Yes, let me see. You're going to have to see. I want to see pictures and shit. We do have, now that I'm at the campground, we've got a little X-Carve CNC machine that I had my parents get for carving signs. And we carved like a bunch of signs. And then we tried carving a really big one with, like, super expensive, never wrought sign, plastic, Delrin type stuff. And the machine glitched out and just, like, carved right, a straight line, like, right through the middle of the whole thing. Just like, God damn it. So, but part of my goal while I'm up here now is to get that working again. So I'm going to be doing some streams from the carving room, too. So that should be fun or interesting. And my dad and I mean, this is Cooperstown, so it's like Baseball Hall of Fame. So that's like the whole area's business. So that's why there's like, I don't know if you can see it, but there's like, these are all baseball bats. And my dad has built a Major League and a Little League baseball field that are gorgeous. Oh my God, people. Your horns, you're killing me. Come on. Thank you. So anyway, we're gonna do a like sword in the stone contraption that has a bat stuck in it. And we're figuring out the mechanics so that like we can choose when the bat's able to get like pulled out of the stone, so like little kids can pull it out but grown-ups can't. So that's gonna be fun. I'll probably stream some of that project too, just to, because it might be fun. Yeah, I've wasted some Delrin, right? Hoping I might get a 3D printer this fall. Yes, do it, and then come take my class. Or just hit me up for free advice, because I tend to do that also.
What kind of, how much money are you looking to spend? You got a budget planned out yet? Like, what range? If you want like a more high-end one, I mean, they get into the hundreds of thousands of dollars, but like, you know, Ultimakers are a couple grand and they're gorgeous. And then you've got like, you know, crappy no-name ones or the Ender on the low end, Ender 3 and those. Maybe it's by weight, stand on the spot and pull the bat. Well, actually what we're doing, yeah, that's an interesting idea, but that's pretty complicated. We're thinking of just using some a car jack, a scissor jack, because like once that's locked in place, you're not getting that out of there. And then if we have like a worm drive or something that spins and goes off somewhere else, even through the ground, you could control the jack and whether it pinches or releases. So I don't know, we're gonna do some prototypes and see what it goes. Starter model for sure, I was looking at Prusa. Prusa, right, not Prussia? Prussia is a country. I bet that was auto correct. Prusas are good. Yeah, there's a big, good community behind that too. And there's a lot of room for upgrades on that. So like you can kind of get a base model and then work your way up, you know, as you need to better components and things that'll last longer, stuff like that, more accuracy. But I haven't really looked into that community yet, but I know that it's quite hefty. But I'm also happy to look at anything if you want to send it to me. I'm not the be-all, end-all, but, you know, I'm happy to lend a hand or share an opinion of whatever. Look up some reviews, see what people are saying about it. I know you're perfectly capable of that, too. Yeah, I was looking at Prussia. Yeah, on my damn phone. Prussia used to be Prussia, is now Russia, right? I don't know. All right, so there's a big ass one. Bush. Ants, get off me. God, I'm such a city boy. I'm glad none of my family is around to see me freak out about ants. I'd be like, don't they have ants in Atlanta? I'd be like, yeah, but they're red and they bite you, so you can see them better. I should scrape some of that off. That's the other exciting thing about oils, is you can like scrape it off. Don't like where it's going? Scrape it off. Ooh, I caught it. I dropped my brush and I caught it. That is the position I played when I played baseball. Somebody's coming with the tractor. Oh, stand up time. Man, there's so much cool shit here. Yep. It's my dad on a tractor. Going with the honey wagon. AKA the shit bucket. Scoop out some campers stuff. Let's see if this cadmium, whatever it is, this green stuff, what is that? Cadmium green pale. I liked it, it was nice and vibrant, but it seems like I can get pretty much the same color from yellow and cyanish. Pretty much. It's a little nice. Alright, let's get some white in there. Scooby-dooby-doo, where are you? You got some things to do now. Scooby-dooby-doo, where are you? Don't know the rest of the words now. Oh, I stuck this thing right where I have to look too again. Right in my field of view. Turning into mush. Mushy mush mush. Okay, I do want to get some